All right, we're here. We're back. Everything's working. Oh, what a beautiful world this is.
Okay. Yep.
So I guess I cannot use the encoder on my graphics card. It was working just fine for a long time there. Since I got the computer, it was working fine. But
Don't know.
I was getting a lot of drop frames because of my encoder. When I switched to a different encoder, I stopped getting drop frames. I don't know. Everything likes to break on me. So we're gonna go with this and hope that fixes the issue. I still don't know if they're gonna do maintenance or not. I really wish they would tell you ahead of time, but my internet company doesn't tell you. They just limit your, because they limit it enough that you can still use it. So like I would get 150 download, and suddenly it will now be like 50 or less for that time period. So they make it so it's still there,
Yeah.
but the upload goes from like 10 to 1 or 0.5. So it's obviously not viable for streaming.
Yeah.
They don't tell you ahead of time that they're going to do maintenance on your internet line because it's like the main internet line. You think they'd send something out, but they don't.
No, that would be courteous.
No, yeah. But what can we say? We at least got things going. I can do this. Yeah, go.
Cat, please.
He's going to go behind there if you're
Yeah,
not
I know.
careful. Sorry, Rusty is just like a ball of
Energy.
energy and wanting to mess with everything around him. Everything and anything that he can mess with, he has tried to.
Sneeze. Let me get the
Okay.
tissues.
Oh, okay. I muted for Greg, but now he says he's gonna go get the tissues. But that's fine. I have you guys. We have
Yeah.
each other.
You can start without me. What am I gonna do? Bumble?
Probably. He also had a message from his work that he had to answer, so he was going, took a little bit longer, but no drop frames at all. Not even a single one. So let's just hope they don't do maintenance. We'll find out in like an hour. All right, I don't remember what we were doing last time. I know we're Watson. He's doing that. Not sure what we're supposed to be doing.
Dialogue.
Okay. Check dialogue. Bring me your registry of the hospitals. Okay. I'm guessing that's in his room.
Probably.
Oof. As I fall.
I mean, here.
Any Cthulhu
Here
statues?
is where I write my stories about Holmes's cases, and I've got work to do.
Yeah.
Hello, everybody.
Greg's
I'm
back.
back.
Okay, maybe it's not here.
I mean, I never left.
Are we supposed to be going to the bookstore?
No.
And this is how my dear friend and colleague treats his clients' letters.
I like how he looks at stuff and says stuff differently about things.
The harpoon that was used to kill Black Peter. A horrible murder.
Okay. What else can we click on? What else can we click on? Oh, we're going inside this room. Anything to say about anything here? Nope. Not a thing, huh? No comments about. Oh.
This bust was used to fool Colonel Moran during the case of the empty house.
Oh.
The Holmesian? I got an achievement.
We got Chivos?
I got an achievement for looking at things. Guess I saw all of the old story stuff from the book. Okay, well, we have not found
Cthulhu.
Anything of use here. Is Cthulhu here?
There's no Cthulhu. We haven't found Cthulhu. I was completing your sentences. We haven't found Cthulhu.
Oh, okay. Yep, nope. The relics of the other games are not in this one, it looks like.
I guess we have to go to...
Have you found your book?
No, I haven't. I've not found my book.
Have you found your book?
Oh, okay. I guess I can't leave the house.
Wait.
Is it in my inventory? No. Okay, I waited. Oh!
General practitioner? That won't be of any use to me.
Okay. We're here somewhere, then.
Hospitals and dispensaries in London.
Hey. I guess it makes sense.
Good. Put it on the work table, will you?
Yeah, it's in the bookcase. I guess that makes sense, you know, it's in the bookcase.
Yeah.
Oh shit, what did he say he wanted me to do with it?
Put it on the work table.
Okay, this is the work table.
Here is the section showing Whitechapel. I made several notations on these pages during our investigation into the Ripper, which might prove useful. All we need to do is to find a hospital or a public dispensary near a location where pits have been dug and black granite has been used.
It's simplicity itself.
Horrible.
I haven't finished my analysis.
You have not? Then sit back down. Why did you get up?
Okay.
The rope was only
worn on
one side. There was no need to be with a worn side. I fairly doubt that's that.
In the middle one?
That? Okay.
I think we gotta figure out what everything
is. Oops. Okay, the damp earth brought in by the Bishop of Kingsbridge's killer.
Uh-oh. The killers. So it was from a pit.
It was from a pit, wasn't it? Oh no, a riverbank?
Go back?
Can I?
Can you click the bottom?
I haven't finished my analysis.
That's not what I meant.
Where?
This. Can you click on that?
Yeah, it just shows you that.
What was it?
I haven't finished my analysis.
Can you look at our inventory?
Yeah, I want to relook at the things. Oh.
This menu is not available.
Oh, look, we can see the things we got. You make it highly effective. Elementary, seems that you share your love for all that is bizarre. You discovered the Somalian necklace. Well done. Okay.
For sure that I might rely on you, you found all the items from my past adventure. I want to look at the scalpel. Because I don't remember what it was written on. It was like WC something.
Don't we write the stuff down somewhere when we... Or do they not do that anymore?
I don't know. Middle one? The chalkboard?
Brings this.
I don't know, I guess sit back down on the thing then. We'll have to just.
Okay, so the damp earth brought in by the bishop's killer. It was.
I believe that's what we've indicated.
I think it was a pit. Quiet boat.
Lower something into a pit.
And a painted rock. It was granite.
Yes.
Granite wall painted black. Monuments. Earthen fragment of granite comes from a cave.
Verse 2?
Yeah. Stone factory.
Can we look at the book?
I am missing some information.
That just is where we go. I don't remember if they said it sounded that it came from the water or not. Uh-oh.
I haven't finished my analysis.
Great. Can I? There. Other hand.
You wanna...
No, it is unnecessary.
Oh. But I could, like, remember things. Great. Because we were supposed to do this right after we'd done everything.
Yeah, but then the internet crashed. Could we go to...
I haven't finished my analysis.
Can we go back and just redo it?
Well, can we go to our inventory really quick? Can we go to the stuff in the inventory?
Yeah.
Mud...
I don't remember any of the things about it. It's mud.
All right. Well, let's just go back and click on stuff in the paper. Click on the table.
This came from a riverbank?
Well, no. I mean, because we didn't pick an outcome.
Oh.
Oh, dear.
Everything's still red.
I don't.
I think we need to.
I don't know if we can go back. Maybe that one.
Okay. Thank goodness. Okay. All right. We have to get through this part first, though.
Black and damp earth under the nail.
Interesting.
No, I can't do that.
Knife?
Tooth marks. Rather deep ones. I'd say of incisors and a canine. Fragments of skin. A phalanx. This finger wasn't cut off. It was ripped off.
Bite marks on this severed finger. I am afraid of the significance.
The thieves didn't get what they wanted. When they were faced with the bishop's refusal to cooperate, one of the gang shook his finger at him to indicate that he was responsible for his unfortunate state.
And the poor man, whose head was the only part of him not bound by ropes, bit the finger violently enough to sever it. An uncommonly savage act.
Watson, I am certain that when we have explained the reasons behind this sudden bestiality, we will have revealed a larger part of the mystery.
All right.
There is something written on this scalpel. I should clean it.
What?
I can't do that.
And it was the brush?
Ah, I can make out
WCCH. Whitechapel.
What do the initials stand for? How many hospitals are there in the Whitechapel area, Watson?
If we count public dispensaries, enough to keep us busy for an entire month. Did this scalpel come from a hospital?
Yes, as the initials WCCH engraved upon it show us. We must think on how best to deal with this. We do not have the time to investigate every hospital in Whitechapel.
Okay.
I have cut a small piece off the rope. A lot of fragments of black stone are wedged into this black and damp earth. I must compare the samples of earth that I found. I can't do that. This rope is only worn on one side.
Okay.
This fragment of stone is very smooth, and it's...
We've got to strip it with some acid.
This stone...
And then, I think...
This stone is granite, covered in black paint. The fragments found in the rope and this piece of granite come from the same place.
Okay.
I must compare the sample. And if I mix this earth with another substance...
Water.
Now it must...
I'll be stirred. Can I use the scalpel? Yeah.
The samples of earth taken from beneath the fingernail and from the ropes originate from the same place.
How do you know?
It took just a little water to analyze the consistency. The soil has retained its moisture, even though there hasn't been rain in London for over a week.
This soil could come from the bank of a river, or okay. somewhere where the evaporation is slower. A mine, perhaps, or a trench.
The banks of the Thames are clay soil, unlike our samples, so we can rule that out. The nearest mines are a dozen miles away, so I would rule that out also. I would therefore conclude your last theory to be nearer the mark.
A trench, or a pit?
A pit. Watson, okay. bring me your register
right.
of the
We were
London
right
hospitals.
On the pit. We remembered
Studying
that correctly.
The scalpel has given you an idea, then.
Indeed.
I'll get it.
Okay, now we gotta read the book.
I also have to go redo my thing, though. Hold on.
The harpoon that we...
Yeah, because we went back in time.
Yeah, but... Still have the achievement, maybe?
It probably wouldn't, because we just reloaded it old Dave.
Just look at this your inventory. Bust. Okay, well, sorry.
Hey, we went back in time, meaning the achievement would be gone, too. What did I miss?
Be in the other room.
Oh, in my room? Oh, for my books.
And also the knife that Holmes puts all the letters on the mantelpiece.
And this is how...
Yep, that's how he deals with his client stuff. Look in my room. Stuff here.
Here is where I...
Hey, we did it. Okay.
Get that book.
It's here.
Hospitals and dispensaries in London. I have found my book, Holmes.
Good. Put it on the work table, will you?
Female anatomy. I should put this book somewhere else.
Whoa.
General practitioner. That won't be of any use to me.
On this side?
Nope.
Nope, it was just this side. Okay, so there was a couple books on this side.
A female anatomy. I should put this somewhere else. I can't
Here
imagine
is the section
it being
showing
that
sexy. Whitechapel. I made several notations on these pages during our investigation into the Ripper, which might prove useful. All we need to do is to find a hospital or a public dispensary near a location where pits have been dug and black granite has been used.
It's simplicity itself. I haven't finished my analysis.
We also completely missed him recapping everything.
Okay,
so it's only on one side. Yeah, always used from the same side. Damp earth brought in by the killers was from a pit. We know that. The fragment painted black comes from a granite wall painted black. Or is it comes from a monument? Probably a wall, since it's in a pit.
I mean, we could skip it for now.
The type probably used in a well. Or lower something into a pit.
Probably that one.
Might be a well. Yeah, granite wall painted black. No, it comes from a pit, not a cave.
Yeah.
Pit near a monument.
For the earth.
From a grave that comes
undergoing
repairs
or a tombstone.
Something that under repairs? Either that or maybe near a construction site? A memorial near a cemetery. In fact, this is the only repair site, though. Like, there's memorials and factories and stuff.
I am missing some information.
Okay.
So maybe we're not right.
Yeah.
From a grave? Your grave. No. Coming from a building. Undergoing repairs. Crunch.
I am missing some information.
No, we've done... Okay, so we've definitely done something wrong, because... Maybe rope is used in a well?
I am missing some information.
A painted flag. Fragments from a painted rock. From a pit. A pit near a monument? I would assume it means it's something... Maybe it is a grave.
Maybe.
I am missing some information.
I kind of wish like part of it would like go red or something, or green, to tell you
that you're on the right path.
Because I know it's from a pit. We've already figured that out. And I just don't get why it would be a well, though. A well doesn't fully make sense, because why would the granite be painted black in a well? Unless it's... By black paint, they mean, like, some sort of sealant on the granite? So it sounds more like maybe a monument or something.
I am missing some information.
Make the right deduction based off the facts you... Thanks. Thanks for that instructions.
Unless there's something else we need from the... Maybe if we wander around?
I haven't finished my analysis.
What else would we...
I need something.
He needs something? We haven't done the broken flask, have we?
Oh.
Oh! Analyze the evidence, add liquid from the test tube. Okay, so it had something to do with this broken glass. We hadn't messed with that.
Okay.
Okay.
I haven't finished my analysis.
Oh, okay. It's just there now. Oh no. Now I've done it.
Hold on. Frailty. What are the other ones? Frailty.
I don't know.
Well, you gotta...
Oh. Generation of skin. Why am I here now? Wait, why am I here?
Just calm down.
I don't know what any of this stuff is. I'm very confused. Okay. Oh, there's a restart button.
Frailty, aggressiveness, degeneration of skin tissue, and muscular stimulant. So you want to reset?
Okay. What are these?
I don't know.
What am I supposed to do?
I don't know.
Put from the test. Active agents work out all heuristic. How do I can rotate it, but how do I use it?
Try clicking on the
I don't understand. It's not doing anything. How do I test anything? There's nothing happening here.
Okay, calm down.
I'm just putting ones and
what if we just do this? What if we...
Oh. Okay. Do you put the blue in? I've already missed what happened.
Okay, I can click on that little valve.
Okay.
And that made three of those and two of those.
Two of those, okay.
I don't know what that means.
I haven't finished.
Oops. Shoot. I was trying to... So it made three of these and two of those.
Alright, so this made three of these and two of these?
Yeah.
I haven't finished my analysis.
It's so easy to accidentally click out of this. Oh, ooh, turned green.
Oh, okay.
All right, how did you do that? This?
The valve. The valve and the tube. Yeah.
Two green, one of the other two.
Yeah. Then that one and...
Okay.
Yeah. We already did that one.
We got at least... Because based off of this thing, we didn't actually do it. All right.
So two whites, one...
Three whites, two browns. Two greens, one blue.
Red. Three greens, three browns. Then
poison, and apparently very virulent.
Yeah, we figured it out. We figured out clicking the little sprout. Okay, so the result of the analysis of the poison is it's heightened aggression, close to madness, death by
cardiac arrest. Okay.
Poison, discreet, efficient, and only detectable via a thorough post-mortem.
Have you been able to isolate the active components, Holmes?
Not with any certainty. This toxic substance surpasses my own knowledge in the field. It is, without doubt, the work of an expert chemist.
A chemist and a criminal.
As you say, please find my monograph on poisoners of the last 30 years.
Poisoners of the last 30 years. Not in the bookshelf.
Maybe it's in his room. I didn't see it there.
Although there was a newspaper that was slightly colored differently.
I guess it's not in here.
But there's a newspaper by the chess set that's kind of colored. Yeah, I figure. Sometimes you can tell.
Oh, the fake necklace.
Yeah. At the moment of writing these lines, the famous Samoan necklace belonging to the Marquis de Cunningham has still not been recovered. Our editorial staff remain reserved as the role of the famous Detective Sherlock Holmes has played in the affair. Excuse me. Well, this is not the first time that Mr. Holmes has compromised himself during the course of one of his so-called investigations.
Hello, Jess!
Hey, Jess, how's it going?
Hello. Been having fun times figuring things.
Dave. When recalling the second Stain case, the affair is indeed strangely similar to the Marquis of Cunningham's necklace misfortune. Indeed, Mr. Trelawney Pope, Secretary of State for European Affairs, has a document of extreme value in his safe box, which had been stolen but a few days earlier. Who, if not Sherlock Holmes, could have replaced the documents in Mr. Hope's safe? What's the point of the trick? I'm dying.
Didn't we already read
the paper,
that?
Holmes?
No, I think this is different. It is pretty much the same of...
Blackmailing... this is pretty much...
I think it's them reiterating that. Oh, it's... You know, Holmes is... Burr. Can we look at the knife again?
If it's over here? Oh!
Scotland Yard, Hans Sherman, aka Rat Killer. Okay. This is what he's looking for. Did we take it over to him?
Did it? Die?
According to these documents,
there we go.
Hans Sherman, known as the Rat Killer, was considered the greatest specialist in chemical poison in the world.
Is he at liberty?
Happily, no. He has been held in the high security wing of London's Westgate Prison for many years now.
Then he cannot be the one who concocted the poison.
Don't dismiss him too quickly, Watson. According to Scotland Yard, the man is exceptionally intelligent. For the greatest criminals, prison is but a mere obstacle. Let's plan a little visit to see Mr. Shielman tomorrow.
I haven't finished my analysis.
You bought New World. What is New World?
Yeah, I don't fully know what New World is. So what we did didn't do anything?
I haven't finished my analysis.
Okay, I guess we gotta finish the analysis of this.
Then what did we...
What?
Here, a monument, a building. I feel like it's a building.
I am missing some information.
Maybe check our own personal. Like the one.
I haven't finished my
analysis. The one that we own?
The one that's, yeah, in our.
I can try it. We have learned some new things. Poison.
Yeah. Because maybe this will help us in figuring out what we need.
One of the murderers was wearing his shoes. They were poor. They were hired by somebody. It's the new MMO from Amazon.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah, I was not hearing good things about that before it came out. It was in closed beta, and all of a sudden they started throwing in a bunch of pay-to-win stuff.
Bishop Carter didn't get what they wanted. We know this. Okay.
I was supposed to click on things. Bishop tore his aggressor's finger off his teeth. The bishop gnawed on himself.
He went mad. We know that because it was the
poison.
Poison. Carter had a poison that caused madness.
Wait, did it say was one of them vampires?
Yeah, one of them was vampires.
Our board is finished. It confirms that the bishop's murderers work for one person, who, amongst other things, possesses a very sophisticated poison. They therefore act for someone more educated than themselves.
Yay, we got another achievement. What does this mean, though? Okay, someone more educated than themselves. What, we have to come back here? What does this have to do with anything?
Maybe nothing for right now.
I haven't finished my analysis.
Then what do we need to do now? All this. Now every page's got their green.
What if we just start randomly clicking?
On what? The thing?
Yeah, what if we, like, go back to it? The book?
Okay.
What if, like, top left one? I mean...
With this one?
Left.
This one?
Well, I meant the one...
This one?
I meant that one. What if we just start clicking on one and then...
That didn't do anything.
Okay, what do we know for sure?
We assume... That it was used on the same side. That's why one side was worn.
Well, it was from
the sun. Maybe used in a well or used in, I would assume, a pit, because we're still talking about the pit. Because I think it's here that we hit a problem. So either it comes from a monument painted black or a granite wall painted black. But we know that it's from a pit. I thought it was the pit near a monument.
Yeah, pit near a monument.
Came from, I would assume, a wall or a monument.
I would say a monument.
Because we're talking about a monument here, then maybe the monument is there, just connecting the terms. The tomb factory? Is that the problem?
Right.
I am missing some information.
Oh, I tried the grave.
Now I can make the right decision.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
Because so you had one on the grave, but you didn't have the other one on the. So now I guess
we. Well, I had them both. I had them both on the monument. Oh, on the tombstone thing.
Cemetery.
Memorial, yes, cemetery.
Click on it.
The public dispensary number 4661. It's just opposite the Whitechapel Street Cemetery.
Yes, Watson. The murderer with the missing finger must work in the cemetery, or at least visit it. He could have taken a rope, one of the type they use to lower the coffins into the graves. The granite is minute particles of tombstone.
And he only had to cross the road to steal a scalpel from the dispensary opposite.
You remember Wiggins and his gang, the Baker Street Irregulars?
Yes, the street urchins, whom you employ upon occasion, and Wiggins is their leader.
Yes. Well, I have hired their services again. I have instructed them to find out the address of the bishop's nephew.
I think he's here.
Okay, well, that was a little bit frustrating, but we got through it.
Hello, Mr. Holmes.
Why does the little kid look really old?
Have you found the information for which the good Dr. Watson is going to pay you?
Yes, Mr.
Why does the kid look as old as they do?
I mean,
very well, I understand.
It's the 1800s. Pretty tough life for a homeless kid.
The man you're looking for lives near Kensington.
Does he live alone?
Yes, but he rents a room for an old lady.
Did she see you?
No, Mr. Holmes. No one saw me.
Perfect. Watson, give our young friend another shilling as a reward for his discretion.
Here we go again. But of course. I'm falling asleep, Holmes. Aren't you tired?
No, I have an exceptional constitution. I can't remember ever having been fatigued by work. Idleness, on the other hand, exhausts me completely. Go to bed, Watson. The night will be short. We leave at dawn.
Wow, this is a real adventure.
It's exciting. I like it better than made-up stories. I want to know.
Oh, right, I forgot about this one.
Yeah. I'm going to.
Forgot about the children of the corn.
Oh, I want to listen to.
Wait, were you not listening?
My readers must excuse me if I do not describe in full detail here the terrible images which haunted me that night.
I had a sense that something extraordinary would take place, but I was scarcely prepared for the reality of it.
Next day at
dawn. Good morning, Holmes. Did you get any rest?
I did not attempt to sleep.
Have you managed to come to any conclusions?
I think that we might follow three trails. We can visit Whitechapel to try to discover the identity of the murderers by making inquiries at Dispensary 4661 and at the Whitechapel Street Cemetery.
The poison trail seems more important to me. We should perhaps go to Westgate Prison first to see Hans Schielman.
Yes, and let us not forget the bishop's irascible nephew, whose address we now have, thanks to my Baker Street irregulars. I have located each place on our map of London.
Oh no, do we have to
Holmes,
figure out where we want to go first?
Let me remind you that we still have not been officially instructed to investigate this affair.
Ah, well, we will just have to hide that small detail.
I guess it doesn't matter which way we go. I don't know, is the crafting fun in that game, Jess? Or is it tedious?
Goodness.
I think that's where we hit. The
Dale the Gardens. Oh, this is Chapel Street. Okay.
Yeah. So where do we want to go?
I Westgate Prison. Jail?
Let's go to
so
jail.
Tedious.
Here we are at the famous Westgate
so tedious,
Prison.
You love it.
One of the oldest and surest in the kingdom.
I've heard that it is soon going to be demolished. Don't you find it strange that it still houses criminals as dangerous as Hans Schielmann?
There's nothing strange about it, Watson. The name of this prison is linked with numerous failed escape attempts. As long as it stands, the criminals will fear it.
Good morning, gentlemen. Are you expected?
No, but we wish to meet with one of your prisoners, Hans Schielmann.
I'm afraid that at the moment that is impossible. Access to the cells is controlled strictly. You can't go there without permission from the director.
Then would you be so good as to announce us? I am Sherlock Holmes, and this is Dr. Watson.
The famous Holmes and Watson. What an honor. My name is Brighton. Frank Brighton. I'm afraid that I can't announce you. I'm not allowed to leave my post, under any circumstances. But I'm sure that the director won't refuse to see you, even without an appointment. Do you see the corridor behind the reception? Follow it to the secretary's office. You'll find him there.
Thank you, Warden Brighton. One last thing. Hans Schielmann received any visits lately?
None. And I'm sure because I've dealt with receiving visitors for several weeks now. I volunteered because it's a calm post to be in. We don't get many visitors and it gives me time to write. Just like you, Dr. Watson. I enjoy literature and the...
Very good. Thank you.
He's like, okay, please stop talking.
That was very impolite, Holmes. That man admires our work. You could have given him...
Another time. Let's go and meet the director of the prison.
Sorry, I can't have small talk. I have to go.
Okay.
But we just gotta go straight back.
And where?
Where the what?
Chaperone.
Secretary, there we go.
Secretary.
Let us go to the secretary's office.
Yeah. We found it. Up the stairs, please. Into the secretary's office.
Good morning, miss.
Oh, excuse me, I dropped off. Good morning, gentlemen. What can I do for you?
I am Sherlock Holmes, and this is Dr. Watson. We would like to talk to the director.
I'll just go and see if he can receive you.
Music is
tiredness,
very dramatic.
Pale face, stiffness. I believe that the young lady is expecting a happy event.
It would seem so.
Weird thing to bring up, but okay.
Excited about something? Quick, read all the stuff.
Find it.
On the table.
Get out of the way. I'm trying to look at everything.
Hot tea.
Lovely, thank you.
God. Hot tea.
This small rack is for urgent letters to be given immediately to the director.
Okay. Telephone?
Nope.
This charming secretary is Miss Jenny Patterson.
Okay. Is there anything else?
Game, why are you so dramatic right now? Dun dun.
Are we supposed to go?
What should we do next, Holmes?
I don't know.
What's going on right now? Oh.
The director's office. Mr. P. Patterson. No need to go in there. Strange. The director and the secretary have the same name.
Is that strange? Why is it strange that his
wife... I'm delighted to meet you, Mr. Holmes. I am Paul Patterson, director of this establishment. You wish to talk to me? I hope this unexpected visit isn't to announce bad news.
No, do not worry. We are investigating an affair of the highest importance, one which could potentially affect the security of the kingdom. Therefore, it is imperative that we interview one of your prisoners, Hans Schielmann.
Hans the rat killer? He's been in here for a long while now, and he's had no contact with the outside. How could he be involved in such an affair?
That is what we would like to find out.
And you have been commissioned by Scotland Yard?
Evidently.
Sure, totally.
Very well. I have complete confidence in you, Mr. Holmes.
We're not lying out of our ass and going to get ourselves in trouble.
You should give to Warden James in the guard room. He will show you to the cells.
Thank you, Director.
Keep me informed of your progress. And if there is anything else, don't hesitate to let me know.
We shall certainly do so.
Miss Patterson, you have the same name as the director. Are you related?
Come, Watson. Anyone who might have made the slightest study of anthropology would have noted the similarities between the young lady and her father.
Mr. Holmes is right. I am his daughter. But he doesn't like to talk about it. I think he's afraid of being accused of favoritism.
I'm sure it was your qualities alone which secured you this position, miss.
If you must try out your powers of seduction, then what do you say about using them on the rat killer? goodbye, miss.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
Look, if you're going to... it's like, if you're going to use your charisma, use it on the rat killer.
Okay, now where are we supposed to be going?
I gotta talk to the guard.
Oh, okay.
Gotta give him a pass.
Can't just open every door possible?
Closed.
Oh, because it's a prison. Everything's gonna be locked.
Staff cloakroom.
The cloakroom.
Closed.
Listen. And all right, so the security office was not closed. The secretary's office.
True.
Hey, guy.
Sorry, sirs. I'm on duty. I can't help you.
Oh, pass.
Sorry, sirs. I'm on duty. I can't help you.
I have a pass.
I have a hall Sorry, pass. Sirs. Maybe we gotta go somewhere else.
Yeah, who do we give this to then?
This is the entrance to the ordinary prisoners.
Okay, so we don't want to go to the ordinaries. We want to go to the high security.
Wait. Oh, there's a person.
Ah, you've got a pass for the high security area. It's the door at the end. Go ahead.
Oh, cool, okay. Thanks. I look at the
it
stuff
is
in here.
Potassium nitrate, isn't it?
Yes. Saltpeter or whatever.
In here?
It is about the signing in book.
Okay. Hello.
My name is Peter James, Chief Warden, and this is Deputy Warden O'Sullivan.
I imagine I will find Hans Schielmann behind these bars in the basement.
Yes, the high security cells are down there.
Is this the only access?
Yes, there was a second door at the end of the main hall, but it's been blocked up as a security measure.
Thank you, Chief Warden.
At your service. If you require further information, Warden McKenzie will help you. He's at his post in the basement.
Okay.
Tell me about the prisoners, Warden James.
We only have a few. As you might be aware, the days of this place are numbered. Therefore, we no longer receive new prisoners. Those who are already here are among the most dangerous in London. We have three at the moment. Hans the Rat Killer and the Flint Brothers.
The Flint Brothers?
Yes, two rather simple-minded maniacs who detest one another despite their relation. They massacred their parents and decapitated their neighbors. It took more than 9 policemen to overpower them.
Lovely.
Mr. Holmes, I'm a huge admirer of yours. I have followed all your cases and successes with the greatest interest.
What enthusiasm. Have you ever thought of a career in the police force?
Have I thought about it? It's my dream. I'm going to try my chance once this establishment closes down. I'm studying hard for the examination to get into police school.
Okay.
All right, cool. Thanks,
See
guys.
See you later, Mr. Holmes.
Anything else we can click on?
This device must be the alarm.
The guards must spend long hours here.
Long hours here playing cards?
It is the guards' guest book, perhaps for distinguished guests. These weapons are obviously ready to use in case of emergency.
Hey, looks like that's it for here.
Yeah, let's go downstairs and let's go see the crazy people.
Yeah, let's go talk to some crazy people. There's also a dude down here with me.
Here's the famous high security area.
Warden Mackenzie, at your service, sir.
Good morning, Warden. I have a pass which allows me to speak with prisoner Hunts.
Very well. It is the cell at the end to your left. I'd advise you to walk in the middle of the corridor.
Okay, I'm going to talk to you.
Warden Mackenzie.
Okay.
Anyone else we can look at? His books?
Nope. Mm-hmm. No, we're not actually. Yeah, this should be the right
Hans
killer.
Hans Schielmann, okay. I require some information from you.
So, who do we have here? The celebrated Sherlock Holmes himself. Do you know that for all the time I have spent rotting in here, you are my first and only visitor? I think this is cause for celebration, a confrontation between two geniuses, two extraordinary minds.
What a voice.
I'm afraid that you are not quite as great a chemist as you believe you are, Mr. Schielmann. I will not say that you never were. No, it was certainly true once. But you see, while you are whiling away your days in here, it appears that someone on the outside is at the point of surpassing you, if that is not already the case.
Yes, I heard about that. A chemical poison that eats away at the flesh and provokes hysteria. I recognize talent when I see it, but it's only a matter of time before I win back my laurels, believe me.
What can you tell me?
You find
that
out about this information?
That depends on what you can bring to me.
Yeah, who's telling him things from the outside world?
What do you want?
Do you know why I am treated so harshly? For my meals, I am given nothing but a hunk of bread. And even then, not just any sort. The...
Get to the point.
Never interrupt me! Where was I? Oh yes, the bread. Did you know that with a little rye yeast, a pinch of moss, certain cockroach secretions, just enough light and damp, with a few other ingredients that I will keep quiet about, I succeeded in poisoning half the staff here. Unfortunately, a little something was omitted, which would have made the results fatal. Instead, it merely caused acute attacks of stress and powerful hallucinations. Even so, I got a great laugh out of watching them cry like babies when they saw their most primitive fears materializing before them.
You are a monster, Mr. Schielmann.
Thank you.
It wasn't a compliment.
But of course it was! You others, you ordinary, narrow-minded people, you are afraid of anything that you cannot comprehend. You call me a monster, because what you find impossible to face, if by monster you mean someone who is nothing like you, then it is a compliment.
All right, give us a second, we'll be right back. Yes, visitors. There was no escape. It was my parents.
Yeah.
So we completely missed everything that was said during that little, like, time there.
We might be able to replay it.
There was no way to pause it mid-conversation, so...
I think we can just
Okay, yeah, let's just... What we're gonna replay it. I'm sorry.
Do you know why I'm...
Get to the point.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. The bread.
Oh, okay.
Did you know that... With a little rye yeast, a pinch of moss, certain cockroach secretions, just enough light and damp, with a few other ingredients that I will keep quiet about, I succeeded in poisoning half the staff here.
Okay.
Unfortunately, a little something was omitted, which would have made the results fatal. Instead, it merely caused acute attacks of stress and powerful hallucinations.
So he was trying to kill everyone.
I got a great laugh out of watching them cry like babies when they saw their most primitive fears materializing before them.
You are a monster, Mr. Shielman.
Thank you.
It wasn't a compliment.
But of course it was! You others, you ordinary, narrow-minded people, you are afraid of anything that you cannot comprehend. You call me a monster, because what you find impossible to face is just the slightest fraction of my genius. If by monster you mean someone who is nothing like you, then it is a compliment.
Oh, you a dumb man. Okay.
What do you need?
Very little. Just something to write with. You see, my brain races like an engine with too many thoughts. I see them crackle and explode into thousands of formulae right in front of me. What a torture not to be able to write them down. What a hell to see them vanish just as quickly as they appear to me. Just bring me something that I can write with.
That's all. That seems an easy enough request to fulfill.
But listen, I don't want a vulgar inkwell and a pigeon's feather. No, I need material fit for my talent. I want my ink pen. Bring it to me, and I will be happy to pass on to you a little of my knowledge of modern chemistry.
Where is it?
It was confiscated upon my arrival here. I suppose it might be in my locker, in the locker room. Leave me now, and don't come back without my ink pen.
I would assume the ink pen would be dangerous for him to have, though.
Probably has chemicals in it, yes.
Not only does it have chemicals, but it's probably easily used as a weapon.
What, you don't want to say hi?
Can I talk to him?
Hey, brother! Lucky for you that they caught you before I rearranged your dirty little rat's face!
Oh, he's just talking to his brother. Him and his brother are just having arguments back and forth, that's fine.
Warden Mackenzie, at your service, sir.
Okay, I guess we're not going to ask him about that.
Alright, well...
Just to see if I ask the guys up above about it? Or are we just gonna do this without telling anybody?
Either way.
Like, is that what's going on here? Are we just gonna...
Either way, it's not gonna be good for us.
Yeah. Prisoner's things.
Can you tell me where I might find the locker room?
In the corridor that leads to the director's office. That's where the prisoner's civilian stuff is held. But seeing the length of their sentences, they've little chance of ever getting it back.
Okay.
All right, a key?
Can you open the locker room for us? We would like to inspect Shielman's personal items.
No, Mr. Holmes. I'm not responsible for that. You will find the keys in the secretary's office.
Okay.
I guess we'll go see the secretary and we probably have to steal the keys.
I'm sorry, I do not have access to those keys. You have to go to the other office. Is the map here? Do you have a map of this?
Look like.
Sense. Hoping for a quick travel. They've taken our quick travel away.
No trick travel. Boy, I can freaking talk today.
Oh. Nope. Done that thing.
Quick travel. They took your quick travel away.
Yeah.
There we go. I can speak English.
Miss, may we borrow the keys to the locker room?
You will need authorization from the director to open that door. If you wait a moment, then I will inform him.
We will wait. Thank you.
At least it was instances.
Anything new, Mr. Holmes? Is your investigation advancing? Mr. Holmes, have you been able to get what you wanted from our lodger?
Not yet. We must first cast light upon a crucial point, and for that we require your help again.
What can I do?
We need to examine Shielman's civilian clothing.
Very well, but be extremely careful.
What do you mean?
In that madman's compartment, you will find a strange little coded case which refused point blank to open when he was incarcerated. We did try to force it, but without success.
Didn't you ask the experts?
Of course we did. Experts from Scotland Yard came to examine it, but they came to the conclusion that it was better that the case remain shut than tamper with it too much.
Okay.
I see. Yeah. They were afraid that some poison or other might escape if it was opened.
Exactly. Bear in mind that this man is an evil genius, a master poisoner, and that his poisons are never ordinary.
Keys.
Here's the key to the locker room. I give you the authorization to open it.
Yes.
Good. Thank you, Mr. Patterson.
Miss Patterson, the guards are still waiting for you to put up the duty list. Do it as soon as possible. Without it, the changing of the guard cannot take place. Or had you forgotten?
Jeez.
Dry your tears, miss. I'm certain that your father didn't mean to hurt you.
Mr. Watson, I can't put up the duty list. And when he finds out, he'll be furious.
Why can't you?
It's in my locker, in the cloakroom. And I've lost the key.
Your aunt.
Say no more, Holmes. As you keep repeating, time is against us. Let's go and look at the things in the rat killer's locker.
Okay.
Pretty sure we gotta go in there.
Well, we have the key for that. Her locker. She's lost the keys to her locker. The check room?
That's the
staff cloakroom.
You can click on it. I don't think we can get in.
Closed.
Do we have to click on the key?
Closed.
Nope.
I don't
Where
think...
is it?
Well, because you didn't click on the door that was over there.
Okay.
You missed out. You skipped a door. You didn't click on it. Yeah.
Closed.
Ah, there we go. Holmes seems to have aged. Yeah, everyone seems to have aged in this game. Even the children.
Here is the locker of our friend, Hans, the mad scientist.
What do we got?
Oh, what a jumble.
A paper knife. Blotting paper. This solid box must hold a precious object. Let us see.
Oh, great. His pin is in here, huh?
As soon as the catastrophe came to be known, the alarm from mouth to mouth was blown, and the cry rang out all o'er the town. Good heavens. The Tay Bridge is blown down, and a passenger train from Edinburgh, which fills all the people's hearts with sorrow, and made them to turn pale because none of the passengers were saved to tell the tale. How the disaster happened on the last Sabbath day of 1879, which will be remembered for a very long time.
A poem in Hans's handwriting.
Okay.
A poem. Blotting paper.
Me, Hamlin? With the magnifying
blotting
glass?
Paper. Nothing of interest here.
Okay.
There is something interesting here. There is something interesting here. There is something interesting here.
Hey, there's
several dots.
There is something interesting here. Nothing of interest here.
So there.
Nothing of interest here.
There's 1, 2, 3, 4 dots on this thing. Okay. Hi.
I can't do that. This cannot be a simple coincidence.
C-A-B-R-H-S.
So, C-A. What was it? C-A-B-R. C-A. Oh, B-R. Then...
Okay, C-A-B-R-H-S. Okay, C-A-B-R-H-S. H. You just passed it. Top right corner. Under the O.
Oh.
Perfect.
What is written on that note, Holmes?
Later, Watson, later. We can give Hans his pen.
What was on the note? Wait, did you just take the note and not care about it?
Yep.
Why would we? Okay, what do you know? Oh.
Those.
So we grabbed a note, but we're not gonna look at it.
Nope.
Oh, this seems like a horrible idea. Guess I just go back to him now?
Yeah.
It seems straightforward. It did seem like a slightly easier puzzle than some of the other ones.
What a bunch of incompetence. Oh, if I was as unprofessional as that, there would be murderers running all over the town.
What's the matter? Are you a patient of Dr. Watson?
Very amusing.
I was going on about the dry cleaners in Westgate Street. They've just delivered my ceremonial uniform in the middle of my duty, when I've told them 1,000 times not to bring it until after 6 in the evening.
A ceremonial uniform? You've been promoted?
It's happening.
No, and that's not about to happen. No, I've been invited to a wedding. I mean, I hope to be. I'm in trouble. If the director sees that I've left my post, I'll be sacked without pay.
Give it to me, Warden Brighton. I'll take care of it for you.
Really? Thanks a lot. Here's the key to the cloakroom and that of my locker. I'm really grateful, Mr. Holmes.
Have you got in mind, Holmes? You're not doing this out of kindness, are you?
No, out of curiosity. We will be able to access the cloakroom with these keys.
Okay, which was this room?
No. Straight up.
Oh.
That one.
This one. Book room key. Boop.
Boop, 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 a do.
We're in.
Now, break into her locker.
You kind of need someone to break
into
her locker.
Here is Brighton's locker.
Okay. Guess we put the baking soda.
Bicarbonate of soda. Brighton must have an upset stomach, caused by stress, without a doubt. The name on the key is Jenny Patterson.
Oh.
That is interesting.
Where the heck did he have?
Oh, was he gonna, like, hey, I found your key.
Miss Patterson's locker.
All right, so then we want to use her key, get into her locker, grab the thing, and go give it to her.
Either that or he's trying to get her fired.
Let us examine Miss Patterson's locker.
Cat.
The lock on this box is rather sophisticated.
Incredible. Is Jenny hiding something?
Hey, Nova.
Did you just realize?
Yes, I just realized.
Even though I responded to
him? Okay, come on, Kat. You never said... Kat, please, just lay down. Oh. Please?
It was in the middle, though.
Maybe put all the... green down. Okay, what?
The cat's being annoying.
Where are you gonna go? Where are you gonna go?
It's really very clever.
No,
little Jenny is astonishing.
She's like, what a time, Jen. Jenny Patterson Frank frightened in a single heart with two souls. An eternal love.
A locket, sealing the relation between Jenny and Warden Brighton. Mm. Decidedly, this boy is not a great poet.
Oh, a wedding. They haven't gotten married. She's got a child on the way, and they haven't gotten married yet.
Ooh, boy.
Okay, this is the service
Here
sheet.
Here is the famous guard duty list. Interesting.
This? My Jenny.
Yes, let's get married. Never mind the consequences. Your father will have to accept the fact that we are in love. Think about the baby and don't forget that. I love you, 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 I love you. And I've written you a poem. Jenny Patterson, your heart pounds, mine weighs a ton. Our love has no bounds, it just goes on and on. It's inspired by the great Chinese poets to write it. Be courageous, my honey bun.
A letter from Brighton to Jenny. Barely literate.
Apparently, Jenny is carrying Brighton's child, and it seems that Jenny's father, the director, is unaware of this.
My gosh. He knows it. Really? We're learning all sorts of little information while not doing the case that we're supposed to be doing.
I guess let's talk to her.
Oh, okay. I guess we just
We have
talk
found
to her.
The guard duty cards, miss. If you like, I can go and discreetly give them to the guards.
Oh, thank you. You've got me out of a lot of trouble, Mr. Holmes.
A gruesome murder.
Yep.
A very gruesome murder involving a crazy poison that made the guy go,
Crazy nutso.
Crazy nutso to the point that he bit off a dude's thumb while fighting them.
They tied
and gnawed at his own skin. Yeah, they tied him to a chair, tortured him, and he literally was gnawing at his own skin and stuff. Oh, wait.
We have to talk to the guy at the reception.
Yeah.
Reception
we probably
desk.
Have to talk to the reception. Hello? I would like to talk to you.
Sorry, sirs. I'm on duty. I can't help you.
Do we have...
No.
I guess we just go take the pen.
Hello, gentlemen.
Sorry, Mr. Holmes, you can't go into the basement for the moment.
What?
For what reason?
The door has locked itself automatically. We must enter a new security code.
Do it, then.
Miss Patterson hasn't put up the guard duty list
We
yet.
Have it right here.
Without that information, we don't know who's authorized to take note of the new code.
So Mackenzie is locked in the high security zone.
Yes, but don't worry about him. He's trained for this sort of dysfunction.
Why not ask the director to take note of the code and open the door?
He isn't allowed to, and I doubt that he would run the risk of going against the orders of the administration center. Anyway, the bars in the high security section are joined to the alarm system, which is in that room. We only need to sound it to unblock, but you see, we can't do that now.
We'll try to find the duty list, Warden James.
We have the duty list, Warden James.
We have found Chief Warden James's duty list.
So we would have had to do it no matter what.
Let's see. O'Sullivan, it's you who takes over from Mackenzie. Take note of the code, please, and unblock the door.
At once, Chief. Ah, Mr. Holmes, could I ask you for a favour?
Please do.
I think I can say on behalf of all the staff that we would be honoured if you would care to write something in our guest book.
With pleasure, O'Sullivan.
He's going to use the one guy's pen.
Oh, God.
You seem worn out, O'Sullivan. A good night's sleep would do you good.
A good night's sleep would do me good. You're right, Mr. Holmes.
Is something
we're learning the amount of things that the Automod likes to...
Westgate Prison will soon be demolished.
Oh, it's a sex-based...
I'm spending most of my night studying for my exam to join the police. You understand, I have to think about my future. So sleep isn't a priority.
No, but you seem to find
Scotland
things
Yard
that cause
is always looking for young, competent, and motivated men. Would a letter of recommendation from me allow you to get some sleep?
What?
Doing it again.
A letter from Mr. Sherlock Holmes recommending me for Scotland Yard.
Nope. Biting people is considered a sex baster.
May I use this writing paper? The one on your desk.
A thousand thanks, Mr. Rose.
Wait, can you say bite
thanks.
Me? Is bite
it
me
is
okay?
To Inspector Baines, a good friend of mine. There's no need to remind you that it must be opened only by the person to whom it is addressed.
Yes, of course. I'll give it to him personally.
Bite me?
Thank
no,
you
can't
again,
do
Mr.
it.
Holmes.
It's just all of the.
What about just. Bite. Nope, bite works.
Bite works. you could just allow those. Unless you don't have access to that right now.
No, it's not showing up for me. Oh, I can't
weird.
Do anything.
I think bite me is okay. Bite him is probably also okay.
In the ass.
In the ass. Oh, now it's an opposite order.
Oh, no.
Bite him in the... There we go, we fixed
yeah,
it. It's fine.
At your service, Mr. Holmes.
Yeah, the things that it sometimes decides to mod, this, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know why I don't have the ability to fix that.
What horrible thing is going to happen? So bizarre. Maybe I'll just have to ask about biting someone in the ass on your street.
Warden Mackenzie, at your service, sir.
Use the pen to brighten some things, which I'm sure is not gonna be bad.
Well.
And your pen.
You have what you wanted, your precious pen.
You seem annoyed, Mr. Holmes. I would even go so far as to say terribly worried.
Why should you care, Mr. Shielman? Let's talk about that poison.
I am not talking about you in the grip of natural emotions found in ordinary people who are confronted by the inexplicable. But as for Mr. Holmes, you are embarrassed, aren't you? Are you hiding something?
That is enough, Shielman.
You have kept your word. Therefore, I will keep mine. At this moment, the poison which so interests you isn't finished yet. Its maker is encountering great difficulties in attaining the desired results.
What is the end result?
Now, Mr. Holmes, the end result of any science, as Descartes once said, to become the master and owner of nature. Here we are talking about human nature, of course.
God, this guy talks a lot.
The creator's problem isn't so much the mixture as the durability of his creation.
What do you mean?
You see, this poison was made using rare but very volatile short-living compounds, which means that it is only possible to produce small quantities, which most importantly do not keep for a long time. Conceiving such a product in a laboratory especially built for the purpose could be achieved by any good chemist. But recopying this alchemy on another scale and keeping it ready at any moment, observing the particular conservation and storing conditions that a substance of this type requires, well, that would need a genius. I doubt if the creator of this mixture would be capable.
And you would be, of course.
Of course.
Luckily, you are going to spend the rest of your life in prison.
Luck is cyclical. It always comes around again, sooner or later. As far as I am concerned, I have the feeling that the cycle is going to be very short.
Yeah, you just gave him a pin.
Holmes, it sounds to me as though this Shielman is implying that an escape attempt will be made.
Yes, we must go and warn the director.
Okay. I miss the fast travel.
Fast travel, no.
See?
Really?
What?
Okay. Not gonna tell you guys, even though you guys are right here. We could have told any of you guys, but nope.
Nope, it's gotta be the director. You know this? I know this. Must be the director. It can't be anyone else.
Yep.
No one is capable of understanding.
No one is capable of understanding, even though...
It is out of the question that your bastard is named Patterson. Very well. You refuse to reveal the father to me? Well, then go and join him. I'm not stopping you.
I can't.
Director, you will have to postpone this small family reunion. We believe that a serious scheme is afoot. We must act without delay.
You're not thinking of...
Yes. Shielman's words leave no room for doubt. It seems that he is planning an escape attempt. We strongly advise you to search his cell.
Do you really believe that he's hiding something? Because I must make an official report and have a legitimate reason for doing a search.
Director, if this prison is still in operation, it is solely because of its reputation. Think of the consequences of an escape. It would be closed at once. And what post do you imagine would be offered to the person deemed responsible?
You're right. No one will escape from Westgate under Patterson. I will order an immediate search of Mr. Shielman's cell.
Chief Warden James reporting. The search of prisoner Hans Shielman's cell has been carried out. No suspicious items were found.
Thank you, Chief James. I feel better now. Without wishing to offend you, Mr. Holmes, I am glad that you were mistaken.
If I'm not mistaken, we've nothing more to do here. Shall we go, Holmes?
There's just one more thing for me to see, Watson.
What's that?
Him having...
Mr. Holmes, sorry to interrupt you, but Miss Jenny wishes to see you alone. She's waiting for you in her office.
This, Watson.
How did you know?
Wait for me in the guards room. I won't be long.
Also, didn't they find the pin?
What an extraordinary gentleman that Sherlock Holmes is. You must have had lots of adventures with him.
Guess they didn't search?
Oh, yes.
Where he had a hiding place?
Thought he was infallible. But there wasn't anything out of the way in the rat killer's cell. Could he have been mistaken?
I must admit...
Warden Brighton! In my office immediately! That's an order!
Uh-oh.
The director seems furious.
Yes. It must be important for him to order Brighton to leave his post.
I wouldn't want to be in his shoes.
Uh-oh. Did you hear that?
Yes, that's not normal. I've never heard Flint shout like that.
But why doesn't O'Sullivan sound the alarm?
Follow me, Mackenzie. Let's go and have a look.
Maybe I'll come with you.
Sound the alarm first?
No, Dr. Watson, you're not allowed in. Wait for me here.
Maybe very someone well. Should sound the alarm?
Hey, but the grill is blocked, Chief.
We've been locked in. And that smoke, it's coming from below. O'Sullivan, can you hear us?
Sully, are you alive? Answer us, Sully.
What's going on? Can I help you?
Sound the alarm in the guards room. That should unblock the door. Be quick. O'Sullivan might be in danger.
Where is it?
It doesn't work.
I don't know where the guards room is. They said it was just along the...
Isn't this the guards room?
I guess not. Guards room?
There is nothing interesting here.
Where's the guards room? Is it on the other side over here? Oh, guards room?
Locked.
Oh no. Where's the guards room?
Oh no.
Down here?
Maybe?
Hello? There is nothing interesting
here. What about that
here?
Door right there?
There is nothing interesting here.
Either of these doors.
There is nothing. There is nothing.
Entryway?
There is nothing.
Where's the guards room? That's the cloakroom. That was the...
Try it anyway?
I must sound the alarm.
I don't know where the guards room is.
I thought we were in the guards room.
I must sound the alarm. The door is locked, and I can hear shouting and crying. We're in the middle of some family drama, so there's no chance of them hearing me.
Okay.
No, because I thought we were in the guards room.
I tried clicking the thing and it didn't go off.
Is there anything else we could click?
Maintenance?
There is...
No. Nothing else here. Guys? Where is the room?
Hey, what are you waiting for to sound the alarm, Doctor?
It's impossible. It's been damaged.
Okay. Oh, okay.
I'll run and warn the director.
No, Doctor. Our priority is to save O'Sullivan. Go ahead through the visitor's corridor and see if he answers your call.
Very well.
Take the keys. They're in our room.
In our room? Oh, here they are. Okay.
It doesn't work.
Useless. This door is blocked by the timer, but not the one below. Give me the keys, quickly.
What?
It doesn't.
Useless.
What?
Quick, Dr. Watson. Sully might be in danger.
Maybe don't use the keys. Just run over to the door.
Okay.
Locked.
O'Sullivan, can you hear me? O'Sullivan, answer me.
Yes, I'm here. Quick, get me out of here. The Flints have escaped, and they are fighting like dogs. Help!
It's a catastrophe.
But that isn't O'Sullivan. That's...
No, we gotta be stupid.
It doesn't...
Useless. This...
I think you gotta click on him.
This is dumb. We know it's not him.
I've got the keys, Doctor. Thank you.
But it's not him.
Follow me, Watson. We must repair the alarm.
But it's not him.
Finally. There you are, Holmes.
But I can't.
I'm going to turn on the system. Watson, you make sure of the contact.
I hope that this isn't dangerous.
Okay.
Wait, when am I... What?
No. I think you need to use a WASD. Can I see some? I mean, I think you might... I think I...
I don't understand it.
Do we do this?
No. Oh! You have to make it through...
Okay. Okay, I see.
It works!
Perfect.
It's open! Let's go down!
Be careful. From what your colleague said, the flints are out.
We are trained for this sort of situation. And we're armed.
Come and help us, Watson.
Again, that was not...
Everything is back to normal. Thank you for your help, gentlemen.
Were the flints even pleasure. Loose?
But where is O'Sullivan?
He's no longer here. He must have gone out through the visitor's entrance.
Yes, and he must be pleased to have gotten out of the basement.
Good. We must now check all the cells. It's the procedure in case of an alarm.
We'll come and help you.
You are evidently fond of wasting time, my dear fellow. Rejoin me at the reception when you've finished.
Okay, I guess we have to go to the end.
The grate is open! This is alarming. He's fine where he is, under the cover, still.
How can he sleep with all this noise?
I'll admit it's not normal. Perhaps the smoke has poisoned him. I had better take a look.
Be careful, Doctor. He is dangerous.
But it's not him. We know it's not him. We heard his freaking voice. What's in your head?
You seem to have a German accent for some reason. Is the smoke affecting you?
It's impossible. He was with us only a few moments ago. Or else...
Or else it wasn't O'Sullivan.
My yeah, the guy God. That didn't sound anything like O'Sullivan?
The rat Who killer is escaped.
Yeah, Watson's still a damn moron in this thing. I don't understand why he doesn't have any common sense. And they really like to play on the fact that he doesn't have any common sense. Because it always happens when Sherlock isn't here.
It's like...
And it's like they make it very obvious, too, that you're not doing what you should be doing. And it's like you're forced to do it, even though you know you're not doing the right thing. Excuse me, I'm trying to get through the door! Please, let me out. Hello?
Ah, Holmes, there you are. Hans has escaped. I fear that this inquiry is a bitter defeat for us.
Not at all, my dear fellow. Quite the contrary. Follow me.
Why the devil have you brought me behind the prison?
We have an appointment, Watson.
Saving. Even a save.
Look who is waiting for us.
What the heck?
Shieldman! I'll go back and alert the guards.
Calm down. He's harmless.
What?
Harmless.
But what is he doing here? Why hasn't he run away?
Because I asked him not to.
Are you telling me that you helped him to escape?
Quite so, as he wouldn't have been able to do so alone.
But how? And why? He's a dangerous madman. Holmes, you've made me an accomplice in this escape. You owe me some explanation.
And you will have them. But my priority for the moment is to remove our new friend to a safe place. I won't be long, but I must go alone. I'll rejoin you later. Just give me your next destination.
Very well. I suppose you know what you're doing.
How could you doubt it? Here, take the notes. They will help you when you write up the account of our visit to Westgate. So, where do I find you?
I guess let's go to Kensington.
I thought of going to Kensington to find the bishop's nephew.
Very well. Wait for me there.
Okay.
Yeah. It's like... They could have at least tried to have the actor like, okay, try doing an English accent.
Like, try to pretend that you're somebody else.
It's like, try to use the voice. Try to act like an English actor or a German actor trying to be English. I don't... Yeah.
Yeah. He helps regarding the way that he helped Hans escape from prison was extraordinary, that I feel I should better to transcribe word for word the conversation that we had afterwards regarding this matter. I like how they didn't want to talk about it. We have to read it in a note. So, I felt the impatience in my friend's look. However, he delayed relaying me the detail of his incredible achievement. He began by telling me about Hansel's fountain pen. This is what he said. The key to escape was actual Hansel's fountain pen. I discovered a note inside of the locker. I can quote it from my memory. Okay, so now they're saying he did read the letter. Whoever is smart enough to open this case should know a couple drops of my masterpiece are mixed together with the ink inside the pen's reserve. If you are reading this note, it means that I am in a tight spot, so understand that my special ink will temporarily destroy the will of anyone it touches. Therefore, if you have a few precious seconds during which you can shape the subject's will.
Okay.
If you recognize my genius, use this knowledge to get me out of this embarrassing situation that I am undoubtedly in. The instructions of the further escape inside the case secured by a devious combination, the way that he could ensure that none of the prison staff would find it, other than the well-informed friend. Understanding this, I decided to play along with him, but with a double game of my own. I would help him to escape, but I would also keep him under control by using his own creation on him. Okay. I allowed him to commence the game by giving him his pin. Then I started advancing my pawns. My first move was to persuade the director that it was necessary to search the cell, therefore pass the ball into Sherman's court by giving him the opportunity with Warden James. He did not waste it. He coated the bars of his cell with the poisoned ink, and Warden James, whose hands were contaminated, was under his control for a few seconds. He discreetly and simply ordered James to give him the keys. The ball was back in my court. Now I had to find a way to neutralize Warden Sullivan, who was to be the basement guard, as we discovered when we found Miss Patterson's duties sheet. Okay, I must admit that the young warden simply helped me enormously by asking me to sign the prison's visitor's book. Absorbing in the tale, yeah. I went over the chronicle events in my mind. I remarked that Holmes had already signed the visitor book before giving Shulman his pen. He replied in the most annoyed tone, exactly as I anticipated, and it was because I had managed to get the step ahead of the game of Schitzman. I hit 47 ninja last night, and I have most of my
armor now,
except the chest piece. Yeah, they do that sometimes for weird pieces you don't have, but you're getting there. You're slowly getting there.
Woo. You be a ninja.
Okay, so leading the race, all of them in a while. Yeah. Did not expect to use poison. Sylvan being asleep in the godsend, therefore was not suspicious of the blood or the reference he found inside the warden's pocket. Holmes then returned to the point which he broke from the tale and pointed out my lack of paratence to my remark. Oh my god, it just keeps going!
But do not put the cart before the horse, Watson. Do let me continue. So I merely touched the fresh ink upon the pages of the visitor's book. O'Sullivan was under my control. I suggested a state of advanced drowsiness, but ordered him not to do anything immediately. Just sufficiently for him to be unable to resist a siesta during the guard duty. Later, after changing of the guard, Shillman used the keys to let himself out of his cell. He hit the sleeping O'Sullivan over the head and exchanged his prison uniform for the warden's. Oop, sorry.
Sorry, the internet's having some issues. I was kind of watching it.
Oh, I'm sorry. Ooh. Ah, damn it. I keep bumping everything.
Not falling extremely, but it is falling.
Yeah. Then he created a smoke screen by using the ingredients that I had given him. Sugar from Miss Patterson's tea tray, a Brigantine's bicarbonate of soda, potassium nitrate from the guard's room, and sulfur from a few matches. He used the key ingredients again to free the Flint brothers. two ruffians leapt at each other's throats and made the very dickens of a noise. He had the diversion he needed to leave the high security area, and that is the moment where you entered the game, Watson. Thinking that you were helping O'Sullivan, you allowed Hans Schulman to open the corridor and annex his bars by throwing him the keys. On my side, I opened the second lot by turning the alarm on again. In the light of Holmes's explanation, I began to see my actions during the episode from quite another angle. I was troubled by the way that he had used me without my having any idea at the time of the duplicity of my actions. I interrupted his monologue to refer to the guards who had not realized what was happening and who were occupied with restraining the Flint brothers. Holmes continued, exactly. So there was only one obstacle in front of Schulman. Warden Brigginton on the reception desk at the front of the building. I interrupted him again. But it was the director who summoned him so insistently, Holmes. You won't have me believe that he was an accomplice in the escape. Of course not. I provoked the director's rage towards Brigginton. Too impatient, I could not stop myself from asking how. I discovered that Jenny Patterson and Brighton were lovers. I also knew that the director did not have any idea about the affair and that he would surely fall into a foul rage if he found out. I asked him if that was also the reason why Miss Patterson had been summoned. Yes, she knew that I had opened her locker to find the guard duty list, and so she knew that I was aware of her affair with Brighton. She wanted to make sure that I would not say anything. I pointed out that it had been rather unfeeling on his part to have told the director everything, reminding him of his promise to the young woman. He denied it in a somewhat hypocritical manner. I did not say anything. I simply left the lovers' letters inside the urgent correspondence box in the secretary's office, knowing that they would be delivered to him a few minutes later, thereby provoking his anger. The director shouted at Brighton, who rushed off to the secretary's office. Schulman now had nothing to stand between him and the front door. Another question leapt into my mind, and not the least important one. Why did he not simply run away once he was outside? Why did he wait? I was not disappointed by my friend's answer. It is evident, my dear Watson, if he did not run away, then it was only thanks to that aforementioned step ahead of which I told you. It gave me enough time to write the letter of recommendation for O'Sullivan with the poison pen. It was in the pocket of the uniform. Oh, and Schulman could not resist reading it when he found it, but that was written in that letter. Not very much, just congratulations on your escape. Wait for me here. I gaped at him. And that is how the first and only escape from the most unavoidable prison in the kingdom came to pass. A scenario which, without doubt, will prove to be the focus of police college studies for a long time to come as one of the most extraordinary escapes in the history of modern prison.
Okay.
Okay, so he was like, here's a letter.
The bishop's nephew lives here.
Yeah. Yes, he runs and the internet has been good for a little bit now. It steadied itself again.
Okay, that's good.
It just had like a minute or two of it being very upset.
Can so I help
going
you,
for
gentlemen?
A 24-hour stream?
How do you no. do, madam? Oh. We should like
do
to see one of your
words.
Lodgers. Henry
not put those words into the world.
Well, he's away. And you must understand, I don't open my door to strangers, especially with all these prowlers about.
That is the reason for our visit.
So it might be that people are watching or slightly behind.
No, Henry
you might
is a friend of ours. He expressed his concern to us about these intruders.
The internet has calmed itself. It only had one moment of, like, a couple minutes
Mr.
of
Henry,
it being crazy.
While he might seem strange at first, is a thoughtful and kind man. He must have noticed how worried I've been. Why, just this morning some of my washing was stolen, and I'm sure it was those ones who took it.
It seems like the best place to start our investigation. May we step into your garden and then perhaps look into our friend's room?
I don't see anything wrong with your looking over the garden. Can you please not steal our souls,
you undead monster?
You understand? He didn't warn me.
What?
I don't know.
I just understand.
There was like... just seems like a zombie.
What?
What should we do next, Holmes?
Let's have a look in the garden.
Drake's just saying random things to me.
She just looks like a horrible ghoul.
Okay.
This is what I'm getting at.
Oh, and the game is on sale. Lord is conspiring against me.
I know. You want it, don't you?
I'm glad that you're able to play, because it sounded like they were saying that if there was a queue that you couldn't play if you were in the free trial. But I guess maybe it's not actually going yet, because I know our server's been like always having a queue.
I guess because if you buy current expansion, it gets you the previous expansions as well.
I think it's something like that. If you buy the current one, you get a bunch. You get the rest of them. Oh, I saw. Here we go.
Oh, okay. So just keep that in mind, so you don't have to buy each expansion separately.
Yeah, double check when you buy your expansion that you're, how many you're getting with it.
Yeah.
The wire seems long enough. They look to me as though they're rudimentary traps used to indicate the presence of intruders.
Oh, what a jumble.
But it seems like they've already been set off.
Yeah. It's not attached in. I thought I saw another...
I don't know. I guess that's it.
I guess that's it. Neighbors playing music, but I don't think you guys can hear it. They just don't know how to play their music at a decent level.
A wreck.
They gotta play everything at like
Holmes?
Full blast.
Without a doubt, it is the linen belonging to Henry's landlady.
Watson, have you ever seen cartoons before? What are cartoons? The 1800s. Never mind.
Closed.
Put the rake up in front of the door.
There should be a spade here. A small pickaxe.
Are we missing a spade? Let's look around the area one more time. Do we see a shovel anywhere?
Unless it's gone. Maybe. It's stolen.
Yeah, maybe that's what it's hinting at. We had a rake.
We also have a hoe.
What? Oh.
Or a spade.
Oh, wait, we do have the spade. Okay.
Yeah.
Is there a reason we just grabbed all these things?
I don't know. Oh, what? Why couldn't we go in?
Go in where? What?
Closed.
Believe.
No, it is unnecessary.
Okay. Oops. Back into the garden. Do we have to dig in our garden?
Well, there's nothing to interact with.
Closed.
Just gonna rake it.
Closed.
Raking it, man!
Rake the door.
Alright, you can't do anything here. Oh.
This window overlooks the room belonging to the nephew of the Bishop of Knightsbridge.
Okay. Can we look in?
Hello? Okay. What if we try this?
Oh, wait.
What?
There's a hole. Oh, or we can look at that.
What should we do next, Holmes?
No, not you. This.
Indeed, there appears to be some linen missing.
Out of my way. Okay, we're trying to do this. See if we can find anything else that needs picked on.
Because it seems like there's a hole in the gate by the where the linen is right there.
There is something interesting here. I can't do that. I can't do that. No, it is unnecessary.
What about...
I can't do that.
Oh, wait.
This board has been placed or replaced recently. It fits more smoothly than the others.
About your knife?
No, it is unnecessary.
Rope?
No.
Spade?
No, it is... Good, we can pass.
Oh.
Smash. It was like a peephole.
It is just as I thought. Here's an ideal view of Henry's room.
That confirms that the young man was being watched.
Okay.
Newspaper.
This newspaper is 4 days old. The bishop's nephew was being watched long before his uncle's murder.
Okay.
Okay.
So half of London is in a serious food crisis.
Uh-oh.
The remains of a small meal. Someone has stayed here rather a long time.
Okay. Well, at least 4 days.
Could have been watching.
Nothing of interest here.
Long before that.
Yeah, that's what I said, at least. Smallest amount of days has to be at least. Could have been more. Well.
To let.
Let? What the heck?
Probably to rent. Can't do anything else over here. Get into first person? Sure.
No, I don't want to get into first person. Uh-oh, the internet's crashing again.
Oh no.
Internet's crashing this time.
Hi.
Crap.
It's like we kind of figure it out, and then the internet is like, nah. Unless they're doing their maintenance.
I think they might have started the maintenance. Well, it's not like, well, not doing great.
We might have to save.
Yeah. Well, we went for 2 hours at least this time, so we got a little more done today. But we will kind of just stop it here, because the internet is hitting zero constantly and forever. So, thank you everyone for watching. I'll let you know if we end up doing stream tonight, but I have a feeling since the internet's still fighting us, I'm not sure if we'll be able to or not.
We'll find out later.
We'll let you guys know. Thank you everyone for watching.